Time to talk
with Tony J. Hey guys, how's this going? Welcome to Time to Talk with Tony J. I am your host, Tony J. That would be me. And I just kind of want to give you a little background information on myself, let you know what I'm about, what I want this show to be about. And basically, that is nothing. Just whatever I feel like talking about, I'll bring people on, whatever we decide, for your enjoyment, hopefully. Definitely. I'm a senior in high school. I drive around in a very beautiful orange car named Ginger. If you ever see her, give her a honk. She's a nice neon. But yeah, and so I hope you enjoy the show. It's gonna be just fun. I'm gonna bring people on. We're gonna talk about stuff. It's good times. I'm not gonna be whining about, oh, like this, you know, sub this or whatever. The subscribe button is truly there for your enjoyment, not mine. If you like it and you want more of it, I want to be informed of this, hey, by all means, hit it. If you like it, but, you know, you don't, oh, you're like, oh, I can find it by myself, I'm fine with that, I really don't care. I would ask, though, if you do not like it and you just drop a dislike, please give me a little explanation. Oh, why don't you like it, maybe? Drop a comment. Thanks, guys. Hey guys, this is a little segment I like to call Flashback, where I just look back on the years of my life, see what I like, what I've regretted, you know, what I've really loved. With me today, I have a good friend, Ryan Garcia.
Hey everyone, this is Ryan Garcia, a good friend of Tony Jones for quite a few years to come, or have been.
So I don't know how many of you are aware, probably little to none, but there was this, basically I'd like to call it a phenomenon in YouTube, very, very little recognition it received, however.
Yeah, I had about a two-year wave just kind of stopped, though. We had our own show, we did great things, our youth was shown through our experiences on the camera. It was just not a great time to look back on now.
Called the Ryan and Tony Show, and he's Ryan, I'm Tony, quite obviously. And yeah, really, it was just we did it. You want to tell me how we got started?
Well, our freshman year, we happened to be paired in our same English class. Me and him were quite bored with our teacher. She was some new lady that no one was really interested in, really bland lady. Me and Tony liked to shake things up. Before class started, me and him got together, you know, talked, made some foolish comments to one another, recalled weird things that happened, and the idea just kind of shot off right there.
We basically decided, hey, let's do this in front of a camera, let's film it, add some more people, and yeah, we just did not have the resources, the time to make it really phenomenal. I think our best, actually it was a terrible video, but the one that got the most views was about 330 views, which is just not great.
It's great for us, but yet not great YouTube worldwide.
Right. We'll definitely post a link in the description to the
actual website, all that.
Right.
Junk.
Yeah. Sorry about that. I blanked out. So yeah, we had this cameraman. His name was Randy. And the first show we did, I had not had Movie Maker yet. We were very not tech savvy.
So the whole show pretty much had to be shot in one continuous video. And the great thing was is that, you know, we really got into it. We started off the show with a music video. I don't know what. We were dancing in Tony's room. Great times. Of course, we ran off screaming weird things in the darkness. It was really strange.
We had about 15 minutes of this video shot, and we stopped. And we looked at the camera. Our cameraman tried to zoom in, failed, and hit the stop button a minute in. So we got none of this on tape. It was just a bad experience.
We, of course, had 15 minutes of running time happening for no reason, not even recorded. We vaguely remembered everything, but, of course, the second time was just not quite the same. We had to do it again, and it was just not great, but...
Yeah, not good. Well, guys, thanks for paying attention. Check out the link if you want. Please don't say that it was crap, because we know it was crap. This has been Flashback. Bring, bring, bring.
Lunchtime. Let's make it awkward.
People of this great nation, this is a segment I like to call Lunchtime. Now, I was gonna say, for those of you that don't know, I'm pretty sure nobody knows. I have Ryan again with me, and we had lunch together last semester, and he would just come up with these weird things. Like, he'd stare off into space for a while, and he would just say, like, these weird things. A lot of them I don't want to repeat, but they were good times. And so I asked him to come on, and you know, don't tell me what it's going to be, and just make a topic, and we'll see, you know, how it goes. And so Ryan.
Yeah, so today I was like thinking, Tony's like, oh, hey, you know, think of a topic that, you know, might be controversial, but, you know, interesting to talk about at the same time. So I'm thinking, driving on my way here, what can I talk about? You know, talk about people, talk about something like that. All right, so I'm like, wait a minute. Let's talk about what it would be like if the world had people that were always naked. Would that make the world interesting?
Okay, okay. I'm pretty sure at one point that did exist, like...
Yeah, sure. But do you think the invention of clothes was done just to keep us warm or for those insecure people that just didn't want to show off their bodies?
I'm sure it started as warmth, because, like, I mean, first cavemen, it was cold times, like, no global warming for them.
Yeah, but for some reason I think that the reason clothes remained on people was because they were ashamed of their bodies. They just didn't want to show it. Of course, people that are a part of nudist colonies, they're like, hey, you know, let it flap out, show
right.
it, got it,
and they're definitely happy people.
They're happy.
I've never met one. Janelle, you know Janelle.
Yeah.
She actually, I guess when she was little, her parents would take her to, like, this nudist camp or whatever.
Sure, sure.
Yeah.
How was that?
I always thought it was, I don't know. She said, like, she was pretty little, so she didn't think of anything.
Yeah.
But I think that would be a little weird.
But I think the strange thing is that if you think about it, if ladies don't wear bras, they will be savage. You know, these girls are going to be 15, 20 years old, and they are flat and nasty. You know, sometimes things need to be covered up. Like, I don't know.
Yeah, I get where you're coming from, definitely.
Like, I don't know if you have seen National Geographic, whatever.
Okay.
Well, we got some magazines in the bathroom, you know, whatever. Reading my...
Wait. I'm just saying, we were on the topic of breasts, and you say we've got some magazines in the bathroom.
whoa, easy, boy. Yeah, you know, I'm just trying to relate this to the world.
I got you. Go
well,
ahead.
There's some photography in there that might be controversial for some young ones, but, you know, it shows people in Africa, you know, poor tribes and things like that.
Yeah.
And these ladies, they got new clothes on. The guys got no, you know, pants on, and everything's just hanging out, you know, yeah. Hello there.
They're just all chill?
Yeah. Well, does this, the whole idea of not wearing clothes, does it make you more excited about the opposite couple not seeing, or the opposite sex seeing their display?
No, I think, honestly, I don't know how that would work, because you gotta unlearn everything that you've, like, thought of. I think, basically, like, arousal would be completely...
I think it would be difficult.
I don't think it would be difficult. I think it would be more of, like, a connection thing, and there would have to be... It would be less looks only.
Yeah,
like,
yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Sure, I understand that. Like, you know, it's... don't you think it'd be more fun tearing some clothes off rather than just seeing the same thing every day? You're like, hey, I'm really macking on Brittany today. She's really making that food great today. I really want a piece of that. You know, you're going to say something like that. You're not going to say, like, oh, my gosh, look, she is pretty much hanging out her clothes. It's great, you know? You're not going to say that if you're not wearing any clothes. And it's going to be like...
That's true, right?
You got to think about something else than, you know, what's already there.
Right. And I suppose this also brings up the topic of, well, should nudist colonies be more prevalent? Like, if there are people that think that way, should they be more... less sporadic?
Well, I think they can do whatever they want. You know, if I walked by and I saw a girl that was with no clothes, you know, hey, power to me. But
right.
If I see some guy, like, you know, with, like, a squirrel, like, chilling out in his area, like, I'm not going to be a fan, of course, but, yeah.
But
I don't...
seriously, I mean, it's not going to happen around here. I mean, there are laws to prevent public indecency.
You know what? I've seen shows and they make walls, so, you know, you can't see what's in, but...
I guess so, yeah.
I don't know. I just think it'd be a great idea, but, you know, I'd never be a part of one, because...
Right.
Yeah.
I feel like if it's from birth, it wouldn't be weird, but starting it, like...
Yeah, starting
like,
it
if
new.
You grew up like that, it wouldn't matter.
Yeah, I think it's, it's nice to think about, but yet there are some downsides, and I think it'd be, better if we were not a part of one, but
definitely. I feel like there would be some awkward moments in your early teen years.
Yeah. Well, hello, Billy. How are you doing?
Oh, I see how you are doing.
Quite early in the morning, you are happy as a piece of wood.
Oh, I would love you guys. You know, your thoughts on nudist colonies and whatnot. Just leave a comment or whatever. Once again, guys, I'd just like to say thanks for watching the show, my first ever episode of Time to Talk with Tony J. If you liked it, definitely stay tuned. I'll be posting up a new one. Just to let you know, I know Ryan participated a lot in this one. I will have other people on. Although I'm sure you guys love Ryan. He's a very likable character. If you guys have any ideas for topics or things you'd like me to do, definitely drop a comment. And I'd like to instate this. I've never seen this done before. If you have a topic you think would be fun to do, hey, post a comment. And if you want to talk about it with me, you know, you got Skype. Definitely, I'd love to do that with you. So just send me those topics, and yeah, I'll get back to you on that, definitely. And finally, I'd like to close this podcast out with your words of wisdom for the day. Ladies and gentlemen, love your lover, or your loved lover might lovingly love another lover. And love, that's not lovely. Peace. I'm on some new, don't chuckin' my deuces up to her.